Hello friends, so today we are gonna learn a new theorem called as multiplication by T theorem of Laplace transform. Now what is the statement of multiplication by T theorem? So it is given like this: if Laplace of function of T is some function of S, then the Laplace of T raised to n into function of T is equal to minus 1 raised to n d by ds raised to n phi of s, that means nth derivative of phi of s. So here, why it is called as multiplication by t? So if you'll observe, then we have Laplace of t raised to n f of t, it means our function f of t is getting multiplied by t raised to n term, or I'll say by t. Hence the name is given as multiplication by t theorem. Now we have to prove that this theorem is true for all natural numbers. So now let's start with the derivation of this theorem. So since I want to prove that this theorem is true for all natural numbers n, what I'll do is, here I am going to use a method of mathematical induction, because the method of mathematical induction is used to prove the theorem for all natural numbers, or to prove any statement for all natural numbers. So here I'll say that we will prove given statement by method of mathematical induction. Now guys, what is the method of mathematical induction? So it is a two-step process, in which first step is called as base case and the second step is called as inductive step. So in base case, what we do, that we prove that the given statement is true for first natural number. So now the first natural number is 1, so we'll prove that the given statement is true for n equal to 1. Next, in inductive step, what we'll do is, we'll assume that this statement is true for any natural number, and we'll prove that it is true for the next natural number. So these are the two steps, and after that we can infer that it is true for all the natural numbers. So let's start. So I'll start with step number 1, which is called as base case, where we prove that it is true for n equal to 1. Now let's prove for n equal to 1. So let's start from here. So it is given that let phi of s is equal to Laplace of function of t. Now guys, to prove that Laplace of function of t, we use the definition of Laplace transform. So what is the definition of Laplace transform? Here I'll say it is integration from 0 to infinity e raised to minus st into the function of t dt. Now as I want to find out, or as I want to prove the theorem or the given statement for first natural number, what I'll do is, I'll take derivative on both sides and I'll apply the rule of differentiation under integral sign, which is called as DUIS. So here I'll say this as equation number 1, and I'll say differentiating both sides with respect to S and applying DUIS, that is differentiation under integral sign. So what is DUIS? So in DUIS, we get the differentiation of phi of s as phi dash of s, and we apply differentiation under integral sign. So this is the integral sign. So here I'll say 0 to infinity as it is. Let's apply the differentiation. So it is always a partial differentiation. So it is dou by dou s of e raised to minus st f of t dt. So I'll write down the dt here. Now we have to find out the differentiation of this function with respect to x, with respect to s partially. So here f of t is constant, which will come outside because it does not have s. So we'll get, therefore, phi dash of s equal to integration 0 to infinity f of t outside. Next, the derivative of e raised to minus st with respect to s is e raised to minus st into minus t. So that is e raised to minus st into minus t dt. Now we'll rewrite these terms. So it is integration 0 to infinity minus sign outside e raised to minus st into t f of t dt. And now if I'll compare this term with the definition of Laplace transform, then this integral is nothing but Laplace of t into f of t, because here function of t is this term. So we got the value of phi dash of s. So can I say that therefore this Laplace of t into function of t is equal to, by sending this negative sign on the left hand side, minus phi dash of s. And therefore I can say that Laplace of t into f of t is equal to minus of, now phi dash of s is nothing but derivative of phi of s. So it is minus d by ds of phi of s. So guys, if you see carefully, then I have derived or I have proved that the given statement is true for n equal to 1, where see here the power of t is 1. Here we have minus 1 raised to 1, which is minus 1, and d raised to 1, ds raised to 1. So this was the original statement, and if we'll put n equal to 1, then we'll get the exactly same result. So here I'll say that therefore the rule is true for n equal to 1. So in the base case we have proved that the given statement is true for first natural number, that is n equal to 1. Now let's proceed to step number 2, that is inductive step. So here I'll say therefore step number 2, which is inductive step. So in inductive step, what we do is we consider that the given statement is true for any natural number, and we prove that it is true for the next natural number. So here I'll say that now we assume that the rule is true for any natural number. So let's say that natural number is m. So n is equal to m, and will prove that it is true for next natural number. So the next natural number of m is m plus 1. So true for n equal to m plus 1. So let's start with this. So since n is equal to m, so our statement Laplace of t raised to n will become t raised to m. Here we'll get minus 1 raised to m, d raised to m, ds raised to m, phi of s. So here we'll get Laplace of t raised to m, f of t is equal to minus 1 raised to m, d raised to m, ds raised to m, phi of s. So we have assumed that rule is true for n equal to m. Hence I am substituting n equal to m everywhere. Now on left hand side, we can apply the definition of Laplace transform. So therefore on left hand side, we'll get integration 0 to infinity e raised to minus st into function of t. So here function of t is t raised to m f of t dt, which is equal to minus 1 raised to m, d raised to m, ds raised to m, phi of s. Now, as we want to prove that this statement is true for n equal to m plus 1, we have to get m plus 1 everywhere. And for that, I will differentiate on both sides with respect to s, so that here we can get m plus 1. But if you'll observe the left hand side, then we have integration. So here we have to differentiate with respect to s, as well as we have to apply the DUIs, that is differentiation under integral sign. So here I'll say differentiating both sides with respect to s and applying DUIs, that is differentiation under integral sign. So on the right hand side, if you'll see, then minus 1 raised to m is a constant, so I'll keep it outside. Now, as we want to differentiate this term, so right now we have differentiation, or I'll say the m order differentiation. So mth order differentiation, when I'll differentiate once again with respect to s, that will become m plus 1th order. So because we are taking the next order of derivative, so we are taking derivative one more time, hence that m is becoming m plus 1. So we got the value on right hand side. On left hand side, as we are applying DUIs, what we'll do is, inside the integral sign, we'll differentiate partially with respect to s. So that will become dou by dou s of e raised to minus st into t raised to m f of t dt. Now, to differentiate this function with respect to s, this t raised to m is constant because it does not have s, as well as f of t is also constant. So I'll take these two functions outside, and the derivative of e raised to minus st is e raised to minus st into minus t, because I'm differentiating with respect to s. So therefore, integration 0 to infinity t raised to m f of t outside and e raised to minus st into minus t dt is equal to right hand side as it is, which is minus 1 raised to m d raised to m plus 1 upon ds raised to m plus 1, or m plus 1th derivative of phi of s. Now here I can take minus sign outside, so that will become minus integration 0 to infinity. Next, e raised to minus st as it is, and t raised to m into t raised to 1 will become t raised to m plus 1, and f of t as it is dt is equal to minus 1 raised to m d raised to m plus 1 upon ds raised to m plus 1 into phi of s. So now on left hand side we have the definition of Laplace transform. So e raised to minus st into, this is my function of t, and integration is with respect to 0 to infinity. So I can say minus sign as it is, that it is Laplace of t raised to m plus 1 into f of t, which is equal to minus 1 raised to m d raised to m plus 1 upon ds raised to m plus 1 into phi of s. So therefore, we can say that Laplace of t raised to m plus 1 into f of t equal to, now I'll send this minus sign on other side. So when it will go there, that will become minus 1 raised to m plus 1. And here it is d raised to m plus 1 upon ds raised to m plus 1, or the m plus 1th derivative of phi of s. So guys, now if you'll observe, then we again got the same statement with n equal to m plus 1. So here I can say that therefore, if the statement or the property is true for n equal to m, then it is true for n equal to m plus 1. So we have seen here. So we have completed the two steps of method of mathematical induction. So from these two steps, now we'll infer something. So now I'll go into step number 3 or the final step. So here I'll say that since the property is true for n equal to 1, as we have seen in step number 1, we can say that by step number 2, we can say that it is true for n equal to m plus 1, where m is 1, that is 1 plus 1, that is 2. It means it is also true for n equal to 2, because in step number 2 we have proved that if the property is true for n equal to m, then it is true for next natural number, that is m plus 1. So since it is true for n equal to 1, from step number 2 we can say that it is true for n equal to 2 as well. Now I'll repeat the concept once again for n equal to 2. So now I'll say, since the property is true for n equal to 2, then by step number 2 we can say it is true for the next natural number, that is it is true for n equal to 2 plus 1, that is 3. And if I repeat this process again, then you'll find that the above property is true for all natural numbers. So therefore here I'll say that hence it is true for any value of n. So here we have proved that multiplication by t theorem, and we will use that result to solve the numericals based on multiplication by t of Laplace transform. Thank you.